Hi, welcome to SAS Explore. This session will be on risk modeling and decisioning, analytics for fun and profit. My name is Teresa Roberts, and I'm the global lead for risk modeling and decisioning at SAS. It's my pleasure to talk to you today. Thinking about the risk management universe, there are several market forces at play that are impacting the landscape that organizations are operating in. For banks, there's increased volatility in a post-pandemic economy and a slew of new regulatory mandates to keep up with. Organizations are navigating an ever-widening range of risks, including geopolitics and climate change, continued supply chain disruptions, rising inflation, and subsequent rises in interest rates that are putting pressure on the debt services ability of both consumers and companies. What has also happened is that the pandemic has accelerated digitalization, and that has fundamentally changed behavior. With the adoption of digital everything in the way we live, we work, and we shop, consumers now expect on-demand 24/7 interaction from their services providers, also when it comes to on-the-fly risk decisions. If we take credit decisions as an example, which we are all familiar with. For the traditional banks who may have their own ambitious growth targets, there's also fierce competition from the financial technology companies, especially following the pandemic, considering personalization, speed, and convenience. Then there's data initiatives such as open banking and other third-party data providers that give banks access to a much wider and more diverse range of data points that can act as a catalyst for a more nuanced view of risk. So in short, digitalization has fundamentally changed the way risk modeling and decision-making is done. We are now relying on more data and many more analytical methods and models. So it's clear with uncertainty at an all-time high that organizations require faster, better, and more forward-looking insights to act on. To use an analogy, in the 1950s, a Formula One pit stop lasting 25 to 30 seconds was considered high speed. The average time of a pit stop in 2021, so last year, was a mere 2.5 seconds. And for risk assessments, we've also moved on from the purely judgmental manual assessment of risk to more analytical methods. Of course, there's nothing wrong with human decision making. A human should always be kept in the loop. But there are instances where automated approaches, including the use of traditional models or newer AI and machine learning, can risk assess more accurately and timelier than humans can. The cost of decision-making is also lower too. For example, it can't take months anymore to approve new loan requests. Yet for small business banking, today these still take on average 3 to 6 weeks, with corporate lending decisions taking longer than that. It's clear that more agility and responsiveness in risk modeling and decision-making is needed. For many organizations, at least the ones we speak to, the distance between the back office, where computers are running the complex risk calculations, and the front line, where decisions are made, that distance is still too long. So let's talk about profit. What are the achievable benefits and enterprise efficiencies to be gained? Now, speed also means profit. The quantifiable business benefits and efficiency gains from modernizing risk models and streamlining the risk model lifecycle are significant. For organizations that gets it right, it's a game changer. One of our customers cited a double-digit improvement in lending rates by speeding up their straight-through processing rates. Others have cited a reduction in bad debt from the use of better, more up-to-date models achieved by quickly deploying new risk models to decision strategies. And others mentioned the organizational impacts, such as improvement in productivity by automating some of the manual tasks through process automation, like customer screening and affordability checks, freeing up resources to work on higher value activities. So this global bank had multiple and very old legacy platforms for credit decisioning. To deploy a new model took on average more than 6 months. Their infrastructure was decentralized, inefficient, and could not scale. Their customers starting to take their business elsewhere as risk decisions took too long to process. They approached SaaS to future-proof their infrastructure for the digital world. The SaaS platform offered an integrated single decisioning fabric, as we call it, to help streamline the customer journey and support collaboration across the silos of activities. The benefits of the improved advanced analytical capabilities, standardization, and automation included much shorter model deployment times and a reduction in operating costs, delivering an estimated tenfold ROI. Another example is a large global bank in Asia Pacific who wanted to fully digitalize their SME lending processes using AI and machine learning and API technology. We helped them automate and accelerate their processes from weeks down to days, and that has subsequently improved the customer experience. But what I really like about this case is that the bank now plans to make that innovation available to their partner ecosystem to help with the underwriting of small business loans, also in the rural areas. The last example is a large American bank that we've worked to fully automate their risk model lifecycle. To start off, model development and deployment took more than a year. They wanted to automate as much as possible by implementing machine learning, a champion challenger strategy, considering hundreds of models from thousands of different features to put forward the best model for internal review. The outcomes for the bank included a more efficient and standardized process and an ability to manage nearly five times more models over the span of 2 to 3 years, with only minor adjustment needed to infrastructure and workforce. So let's talk about the fun. What is the role of AI and machine learning? It's exciting to see these newer technologies starting to add benefit to the risk management function. For consumer credit decisions, we see the use of AI and machine learning now embedded throughout, whether that is using alternative data to offer credit access to the unbanked or trawling through transactional data for early warning signals of stress. But what are the benefits to organizations who embrace innovative AI and machine learning to automate or augment risk decisioning processes? I'll mention three areas. Firstly, the newer methods give ability to crunch large and diverse data sets, for example, geolocated data or bringing structured to unstructured data. Then it is said to give you accuracy improvements above that what we typically expect from traditional models, enabling micro-segmentation or the segment of one, for example. And lastly, it can help fast-track the model development lifecycle by automating some of the mundane tasks, like automated feature engineering. Now, we all know that these newer methods are not without risks of their own. Despite their transformational potential in automation, they are often referred to as black box, and regulators, including the Federal Reserve, are advocating for their responsible use in driving fair and transparent outcomes. AI and machine learning are pervasive in our society, and with such an all-encompassing range of applications, we can quickly see why it's useful. Some of the area where it's delivering tangible benefits are for the dynamic risk assessments across the loan lifecycle, be that machine learning-based credit models or income estimation. It can also be effectively used for model approximation of complex risk calculations or in the model validation function to challenge the status quo. Other auxiliary functions include natural language processing, to read news feeds, business reviews, and to assess sentiment, or for cognitive data quality and intelligent feature engineering. As risk modelers, we often need to assess risks without historical precedent. Innovative analytical methods such as AI have ability to synthetically generate scenarios to quantify the impacts of stress on balance sheets. SAS recently worked on a proof of concept with a lender to leverage AI and machine learning through their mortgage application process. They wanted to use facial recognition for two-factor authentication, machine learning for credit checks, and a dynamic property price evaluation, as well as a chatbot to follow up on questions that the customer might have. In addition to its automation benefits, the exercise gave new insights into what customers want and what they are unclear about. A second example is in the area of model approximation. Pricing and economic capital consumption can be approximated with machine learning, often with superior performance when compared to industry standard approximators. Neural networks, for example, are resource intensive to develop, but surprisingly straightforward to execute. This avoids a rerun of the complex model and gives an efficient or good enough answer when it matters, often at the point of decision making. Now, we are happy to see the successful applications of AI and machine learning, but the reality is that organizations are experiencing several obstacles in realizing the full potential of AI. Often than not, the current infrastructure or legacy systems are not designed to handle these methods. As the saying goes, you can't drive a new car on an old road. One barrier to adoption is that some, not all of these models are black box. It's a little bit like Schrödinger's cat. You can't see inside the box, so you don't know if the cat is alive or not. There are several popular post hoc diagnostics that can help shed light on the topic. There's also a real risk that historical and societal biases be propagated through these algorithms, impacting access and pricing, for example. More regulation is expected to make credit decisions fairer. The Consumer Financial Protection Bureau recently highlighted in order to comply with fair lending laws, there's a need for validated explanations when using AI or machine learning for credit decisioning. Then transparency. When the model development process itself is opaque, it's not clear what the drivers are, it then becomes harder to foster trust in the decision outcomes. And then another common challenge is the easy deployment of models and finding and retaining the right talent. With the adoption of the newer methods, there's a need for continuous monitoring. With AI and machine learning, model risks tend to be higher, as the models are generally more sophisticated and there are additional layers of complexity from the use of hyperparameters and post hoc explanations. As these models are often more data-driven, the need for robust and continuous monitoring becomes more prominent. If you think about it, it's humanly impossible to monitor thousands of models and decisions in near real time. So for the wider use of risk models and near real-time deployments, SAS is developing more dynamic and automated approaches. So in conclusion, with SAS, organizations can generate more value from their modeling estate. Model development and deployment processes of half a year can be slashed to half an hour. And by introducing a new centralized and standardized way of work, operational excellence can be achieved, as much as 30% efficiency gains through automation. We also keep up with content that support regulatory compliance and drive business outcomes, allowing risk modelers to focus on the fun of risk modeling. The SaaS solutions for risk decisioning offer easy integration with third-party data providers or with our own or other risk solutions. Thank you for joining today. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. Here are our contact details.